In this video, I'm gonna talk about another basic Substance Painter tool, in this case the Bevel filter. It's gonna be a short video as this filter haven't got a lot of different options or uses, but still it's nice to know about it, because it's very useful to create a little bevel effect on masks, great to detail different kind of stamped text or hard surface detail. To start, I have a fill layer masked with a text and some brick details where I will add the bevel filter. Just come to the Add Filters menu and search for Bevel. You can also add the filter to a fill layer, but it's more difficult to work with and sometimes do strange things, so it's better to add it to a mask. Also, take into account that this filter works better with sharp masks and textures or procedurals with a lot of gradients and blur shapes could give strange results or not work at all. Anyway, on the filter properties, we will find different options. The most important one being distance, that determines the shape and direction of the bevel, being able to create the bevel inside or outside our shape, depending on our needs. This is very useful when we create different kind of stamped text or hard surface details on our textures, because this softer bevel, especially when we are working with height information, captures better the lighting, making our shapes easier to read for the viewer. Then, the corner type option. On the bricks texture, it's a bit easier to see the difference between the two options this drop-down menu offers, round and angular corner types. Then we have the smoothing option, to add some blur to our filter. It's also useful to fix this kind of artifact that could appear sometimes due to the aliasing on those diagonal lines on the text. We also have the option to change between uniform and non-uniform blur. Another useful option with the bevel filter is creating holes or cavities. For example, if I wanted to create a smooth hole or a screw shape, and let's ignore that I could be using a simple brush with low hardness, I can create a basic round shape. Then use the bevel filter to adjust the distance and add some blurring to it. At last, we can add a levels layer to control the shape of our bevel. In general, a levels layer is always useful to control the bevel filter. If you have used Substance Designer where there is a bevel node very similar to this filter, you will also know that a curved node is great to create bevels with crazy and very cool shapes. But sadly, for now I think there isn't any method to add curves like that on Substance Painter. So it was just some information I wanted to add, and maybe in a future we will see that feature added to Substance Painter. Anyway, those were some uses for the bevel filter. It's simple and easy, but very useful to create better hard surface details. So thanks for watching and have a nice day.